world and change it. No villain in Final Fantasy was ever close.
That is true there, folks. That is true. All right. The decisive battle. Oh, we're playing over here. According to Nell, this is his stage here. But let's see how Dylan will fare against this. Here comes that fire right there.
Whoa, and he died. Oh, Dylan.
Kefka's fire there can actually change from small to
heavy
there.
Oh, and Dylan broke
it. Havoc Wing, but he missed it. Crushing blow.
Oh, and he got his bravery back, guys. He's still okay. Dylan's still trying to cash in his HP damage.
Alright, I'm only going to be here for the first round here. And then taking over in my place for the second and possibly third match, there's an if there, would be Brian Takashi, aka Taco. Our third place man who
And Dylan was barely able to land 2,000.
It was a tough match, but he barely lost against Nell, which made
him
lose an opportunity
Nell
there.
Oh, Nell was able to do Thunderfall on
Not just Thunderfall, but he also was able to bring Kefka down to the point of
breaking.
Yeah, no, not just breaking, but also losing his bravery points while at it.
He caused more damage to his HP than
This area here is dangerous all around on its limits because you will be warped back, but the cost of that would be losing some of your bravery points. Ooh, an ice ball right there thrown. There's the thunder. I wonder if Dylan would use some of his moves like Shrine. Looks like we have a crowd favorite here for Dylan there.
At the moment, Kefka's losing, but he could turn the match around if he tries. He could still break him to get that
Forsaken, no, here it is. Here's one of them. But it looks like he stopped. Here comes the Thunderball, and it's a
Dylan's going for the EX core.
Here comes the hyperdrive. Oh, there's the hyperdrive!
And he cashed in 989.
There was a delay of time there, folks. Right when Nell was just about to come close, that's when he unleashed it. Oh, there he is again. Bravery cut right there. Only by a small margin. He's getting hit by that fire there.
Dylan's building that up.
I do remember one last match against Taco when he used to play with Kefka before.
Whoa, that was close.
Nell is taking advantage of this match here by using Thunderfall. And he is landing. Looks like Nell's about to seal this first match here. Looks like
Dylan.
He's about to seal the deal here.
Dylan is down to 130 HP.
You think
he can still turn it around?
Ooh. I know that there were a couple of matches. I know there were a couple of matches. In my match against Dylan, my first two rounds, I was able to deal a lot of damage, but for some apparent reason, he was able to come back and defeat me at the last second.
Whoa, does this look like his comeback?
This looks like it. Because right now, Dylan is taking precautions on this one. He's taking drastic...
Nice!
Close one
and
right there! And there's the break! And oh my goodness, Dylan is ready to deal the final blow!
Whoa, that was
Havoc
close.
Wing right there, folks. And there's the Trine,
it missed!
Trine missed. Forsaken Null, Trine, Havoc Wing. Anything can happen right there, folks. But all I know is that both of them are ready to deal the final
blow.
And Dylan has done it again.
Dylan, he rose back to the top with 130 HP.
Wow.
And now only having two, Dylan can actually close off the tournament. Just finish everything at once. Become the third winner or third in a row. It seems that Nell has summon on him, but if he uses it, he loses. So it's pretty close match. If you were to press that right trigger with circle, it means it's the end of him, right?
Yeah. He's considered an automatic.
He could just change it out, but he's going with this, you know.
Oh, there you go with the Blizzard.
It's a huge risk.
In all honesty, Kefka actually descends pretty fast, so it's actually pretty good for Sephiroth's Octo Slash.
So far, Kefka is in the lead.
already.
Oh, there we go. We got some Octoxoth action.
Oh, there's Latrine. Never dodge too early, Latrine. Let's see what's gonna happen next. Oh, Hyperdrive! See, there is that descending, that quick descend.
Oh, he is building up bravery. Dylan is just gonna save all that up.
Black material. Deny. Oh!
Nice, he dodged. And they dodge.
It seems like they're expecting each other's attacks.
The thing about that is, they get nervous the more times they dodge.
Yeah, I know, right? no, they're not.
They're both level 10.
Fine.
Oh!
Oxlash, that descend.
Seems that Dylan is going for the EX core. Has Dylan ever used the EX core or EX mode yet?
With Kefla? No, I haven't seen it yet. But honestly, his
And Nell got break! He could turn this around if he were to land this. Ready. Seems that Kefka's on the roll still.
Guard. Oh.
And yeah, he's almost out of his break.
Yep.
Dylan is just back from his break.
Flare. Oh! Reflected by Skintel, a nice move.
There we go, another Ox Slash. I'm expecting another Ox Slash.
Skintel. That.
Nice.
The thing about that,
this could be the end, Taco. This could be the end.
Oh, one hit. Oh.
Dylan could win it all.
Dodge. Oh.
This is so close. And, Dylan was waiting for him. He was saying, come at me now. Come at me.
That descend really helps.
Oh, watch out. Oh. Octa Slash. What is Nell aiming for?
He's hoping for him to come up. That's all he's waiting for right now.
Dylan is just gonna wait for him. He is dangerous.
I notice how Nell plays. He uses a lot of his HP attacks.
Whoa!
And dodge.
Nell just put himself in a dangerous position.
Game!
That was a bad move on Nell.
Ouch.
And again, Dylan, the winner. His cousin. Nice, we got a small stage for these two characters.
Oh wow, final stage, ouch.
So Taco, does this mean that if Dylan wins this round, it's over?
It's over. The thing about this stage, unless you're...
Dylan broke. Will he cash it in? Oh, he throws it in there.
The thing about Dylan and Cecil, it is very good. He knows how to spam his good attacks. Like correctly even.
He just needs to figure out the way Nell uses his warrior for life compared to other people.
Actually, Nell actually plays his warrior a lot like mine. From above and then just... And the thing about that, Dylan counts me a lot
nice
against warrior.
Nice counter right there on Dylan's half.
Dark Flame, and you can't dodge above it actually. So it's aside, and he hit the wall.
He could have just run up the wall, you know?
Can't run up the wall if there's no wall.
Oh shoot, you can't do that. Yeah, that's right.
There's no flare.
Oh!
Ouch. He's spamming that.
Right now, Nell is still in the lead with more HP, but Dylan is trying to bring it back down.
That shield does not work.
Now Dylan was able to catch up to Nell. Oh, and Nell does another HP attack, and he's pushing Dylan further away from victory.
The thing about Warrior of Light, he's pretty obvious, but once you forget sometimes.
So Taco, tell me, why does Cecil change his character appearance?
His character is actually a double-type character. Depending on his HP attack, he can transform into a aerial mode, which is a paladin. Or a ground mode, which is a Dark Knight. Right now he's playing as a Paladin. And when he uses Dark Flare, that's a ground attack. So he's transformed into Dark Knight. And there again.
Wow, and Dylan was able to... Will it be the... Oh, it's not over yet. Oh, shoot.
Oh, Nell got smart.
Nell is scared. He is trying to keep Dylan away and steal all his bravery.
Actually, if he tries to keep him too far away, he's just gonna end up using dark flame all over again. Oh, there's Bitter End.
Nice.
And Nell's locking on. Oh, not gonna move worse.
And Dylan can save up for EX Revenge if he wanted to.
She can actually do it.
Oh, EX mode. He turned it on. Is this it?
Trying to go for win. Trying to go for the win. It's perfect.
Oh, Nell could still live.
Oh,
Nell could still survive this.
No, it's over.
It is definitely over. And that is it, gentlemen. Dylan Bahaja just won again. Three times in a row.
Not in a row. Two in a row, one out of it. And
he won all three tournaments in a row.
There's three tournaments? Oh, yeah. There